Why do new disease outbreaks always seem to start in China? The Asian flu in 1956 killed between 1 and 4 million people worldwide. SARS in 2002 infected 8,098 and killed 774 in 17 counties. H7N9 emerged 10 years later to strike at least 1,223 people and kill 4 out of every 10 of them. Now, the milder, yet more infectious COVID-19 has sickened more than 289,504 people across the globe, resulting in 10,556 deaths as today 20 March. All of these outbreaks originated in China, but why? Why is China such a hotspot for novel diseases? In this video, we will look at the different researchers answering to this mystery. But before we start, please subscribe and hit the bell icon for more interesting videos. It's not a big mystery why this is happening. Lots of concentrated population, with intimate contact with lots of species of animals that are potential reservoirs, and they don't have great hygiene required. It's a recipe for spitting out these kinds of viruses. Stephen Novella recently opined on an episode of The Skeptic's Guide to the Universe. South Central China is a noted mixing vessel for viruses. Dr. Peter Disack, president of EcoHealth Alliance, told PBS in 2016. There's lots of livestock farming, particularly poultry and pigs, with limited sanitation and lax oversight. Farmers often bring their livestock to wet markets where they can come into contact with all sorts of exotic animals. The various birds, mammals, and reptiles host viruses that can jump species and rapidly mutate, even potentially infecting humans. Experts are pretty sure this is precisely what happened with the current COVID-19 coronavirus, which is why, on January 30, China issued a temporary ban on the trade of wild animals. There are also cultural reasons why China plays host to large outbreaks. Many Chinese people, even city dwellers, insist that freshly slaughtered poultry is tastier and more healthful than refrigerated or frozen meat, journalist Melinda Liu wrote for Smithsonian in 2017. The public's taste for freshly killed meat, and the conditions at live markets, create ample opportunity for humans to come in contact with these new mutations. Moreover, when stricken with an illness, many Chinese first seek out traditional Chinese medicine, TCM, where practitioners regularly misdiagnose symptoms, then offer acupuncture or ineffective herbal or animal-based remedies as treatments. This drastically increases death rates during outbreaks, and allows infected individuals to return to the public, where they can infect more people. Widely viewed TCM posts in China have already misleadingly promoted an unproven liquid composed of honeysuckle, Chinese skullcap, and weeping forsythia as a treatment for COVID-19. China is also notorious for its misinformation, secrecy, and censorship, which raises the chances that new diseases will fester and spread. Back in early January, Chinese government officials told the public that the new infection spread had been effectively halted. This was not true. At the same time, the authoritarian regime bullied health experts who attempted to sound alarm. The young Dr. Li Wenliang attempted to warn others about the new coronavirus. He was rewarded with a threatening reprimand by police. Li subsequently caught COVID-19 and succumbed to the disease the first week of February. There are some hopeful signs that China is doing away with some of the secrecy that hampered global responses to prior outbreaks. The government is sharing much more data than in past outbreaks, and Chinese scientists are publishing a great many papers accessible to the global community. Still, it remains to be seen how, or if, the country will institute policies meant to prevent future ones. Permanently banning the sale of live animals at public markets, instituting and enforcing food safety regulations, and discouraging the use of traditional Chinese medicine are options that should all be on the table. Without countrywide action, it's a near certainty that China's 1.4 billion citizens will once again be exposed to novel and dangerous infectious diseases. The good news is that China has no more citizens getting infected by COVID-19, as they announced today. So we are hopeful that soon this coronavirus will be finished as well. And let's hope that the Chinese government will control the wet markets. So guys, I hope this will get the point of why the diseases keep coming out from China. Don't forget to subscribe, and if you enjoyed the video, please like it, and here are some more videos that can be informative as well. Thanks and goodbye.